A video is a sequence of frames. These frames are shown in quick succession at a certain pace, which is measured in frames per second, or FPS. If a video is shown at 24 frames per second, we call that the frame rate of the video. The specific frame rate used in a video depends on a number of factors, which are beyond the scope of this course. What matters to us is that the frame rate of our subtitles match the frame rate of our video. But EZTitles already does that for us. Take a look. I have an open project configured for 24 frames per second. I'm going to try to load a video that's at 23.976 frames per second. EZTitles shows me a warning. It gives us the opportunity to change the frame rate in the project settings. If we don't, EZTitles won't open the video. Let's click on Change, and then set the frame rate to 23.976 frames per second. Now we can work on the video. Another factor to be considered is the timecode. A timecode is used to identify each specific frame. Each frame is assigned to a unique timecode, and each timecode corresponds to one frame in the video. A timecode is usually structured as four pairs of numbers separated by colons or semicolons. From left to right, these pairs indicate hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. Now, when we're queuing subtitles, what we're doing is saying, this subtitle has to appear at this frame and disappear at that frame. How do we identify those two frames? By their timecodes, which means that the timecodes on the subtitling project need to match those of the video project. But that's not always as straightforward as it seems. First, because timecodes don't always start at zero. The start timecode might be 1 hour, it might be 4 hours, it might be 10 seconds to an hour. We always need to check and set that accordingly. Second, there may be more than one timecode standard for a given frame rate. The most notorious case is 29.97 frames per second, which has two standards, drop frame and non-drop frame. For the purposes of this lesson, these are two different ways of counting frames. If the video is at drop frame and your subtitles are at non-drop frame, your subtitles will be out of sync, which makes it all the more important to configure the timecode standard correctly. Now, it may be that your video comes with a metadata track with timecode information. In that case, EZTitles will detect the starting timecode automatically and set it up for you. Otherwise, we set it up manually. Let's look at a few examples to get an idea of how that works in EZTitles and go over some best practices to make sure your subtitles are always synced up. Let's open our first example on VLC. We see that there's a burned-in timecode here, so we can use that to configure with EZTitles. Let's look at the codec information. The frame rate is 23.976. Let's open a new project on EZTitles. We'll set the frame rate to 23.976 and the timecode standard to 24 FPS. That's usually the case with this frame rate. Now we'll open the video. EZTitles asks us what the start timecode is. We can use the slider here to select other points of the video. Let's keep it at the first frame. We can see on the burned-in timecode that the first frame is all zeros. We'll leave that value here in the box and click OK. The next step is very important. We need to check that the timecode used by EZTitles is the same as that of the video. If there's a problem with the timecode, we can usually detect it at the end. Let's press Alt-End to skip to the end of the video. We see that the burn-in timecode is 2 minutes and EZTitles timecode is 2 minutes. They match, everything's fine. Let's open the second video on the same project. EZTitles tells us that the frame rate is 24 FPS, so we need to change it. We keep the standard at 24 FPS. Now we configure the start timecode. This time, it's 00595200. That is, 8 seconds to 1 hour. That usually happens when you have a countdown of some sort before the actual program. Let's type in that timecode. Okay. Let's check. All good. Now let's look at two examples at 29.97 FPS. We'll set that frame rate, and now we have two choices for timecode format, drop frame and non-drop frame. How do we know which to use? If the video has a burned-in timecode, you can just check the timecode delimiter. If you see one or more semicolons, it's drop frame. If it's all colons, non-drop frame. Let's open this example on VLC. See the burned-in timecode? It has a semicolon, which means drop frame. We'll set that on EZTitles. Now we load the video and set the start timecode. Now let's check at the end of the video. The differences between drop frame and non-drop frame start showing after the first minute. We see that they match. Everything's fine. Let's open the next video. The burned-in timecode is just colons, so it's non-drop frame. But let's see what happens if we don't change it. I'll jump to the end. See here? The timecode doesn't match. EZTitles timecode is 01020003, whereas the burned-in timecode is 01015929. Let's switch to non-drop frame. Now we see that the timecodes match, 5929, 5929. By the way, this drop frame, non-drop frame distinction also applies to 59.94 frames per second. Now, everything we've talked about applies to videos with a burned-in timecode, but what if there isn't any? In that case, you can usually set the start timecode to 0 and the timecode standard that's closest to the frame rate. For example, if your video is at 23.976 FPS, you can usually adopt the 24 frame per second timecode standard. But it's a good idea anyway to talk to your client or to the post-production department that's going to use those subtitles. However, if your video is at 29.97 FPS or 59.94 FPS, then you should always ask whether it's drop frame or non-drop frame to avoid any sync problems. By the way, it's always a good idea to have the starting timecode and timecode standard sorted out before you add any subtitles to the project. Otherwise, you might have to convert the timecodes and requeue all the subtitles, which means additional and perhaps unnecessary work. Your assignment for this lesson is to set the timecode correctly on the provided videos. All of them have the same resolution, but they have different frame rates and starting timecodes. Some have burned-in timecodes, and some don't. Don't forget to check the answer key.